Greetings everyone, this is Michael yet again, and welcome back to the channel here on YouTube. Well everyone, today I wanted to give my thoughts on a film that, you know, quite honestly, as a science fiction fan, I should have watched this film a long time ago, but I never got around to it until recently. And it's one of those movies where, you know, it's considered important in terms of science fiction. It's one of the innovators, one of the earliest science fiction films. And, you know, quite honestly, guys, I'm a little bit embarrassed that I hadn't seen this movie already. And I should have, and I've been meaning to watch it, but I just never did. But I did finally see it last week, and that is Georges Méliès' film, A Trip to the Moon. And in terms of being a movie itself, it's really a short film. I think it clocks in at around 12 to 14 minutes, depending on what version of the film you actually get to see. But this is a restored version of the film. I actually purchased this on eBay. I had been looking for the movie for a very, very long time, and I finally found it on DVD. And I'm not even for sure if there's any releases of it on Blu-ray, but this movie came out in 1902, a very, very long time ago. And I had heard many, many science fiction fans talk about this film and its impact on science fiction. And it's one of those films that, honestly, I didn't know if I would like it, but I felt like in terms of its importance to science fiction, even if I didn't like it, I could respect it for what it brought to sci-fi. And, you know, as far as the story goes, a group of people, you know, create a spaceship, go to the moon. They learn that there's hostile life on the moon, and it becomes a struggle to get back into their spaceship, return to Earth. And basically, there you have it. You know, it's a very, very short film, so there's not really a whole lot of time put into the story itself. And I would say that, you know, I would agree with, you know, sci-fi fans in that it's more about its relationship to science fiction and what it's brought to science fiction. Because when I look at it that way, I can see the importance and the value that many fans place upon this movie. Because I don't think it's just going to be a movie that people are just going, or at least a lot of people are not just going to say, oh, A Trip to the Moon is my favorite film. It's a great film, and so on and so forth. But you're going to look at it from a historic standpoint, and you're going to say, yeah, it's really, really innovative. And even to this day, as old as this movie is, when I watched it, I was impressed by what they were able to accomplish. I was impressed by Méliès' imagination. I was impressed by some of the imagery, some of the special effects. I mean, we're talking about 1902, so you can imagine imagination. I mean, you know, when the rocket ship lands on the moon, it actually does puncture the eye of the moon. You know, you hear about the man in the moon, and we literally have a man in the moon. Now, for many years, this film had been incomplete, but luckily, in 2002, they found a complete copy of the movie in a barn in France. And the film stock had not deteriorated. And they discovered also that it had been hand-colored. And they were able, through years, to go in and put the film back together and present it the way Georges Méliès would have completed the film himself. So that's an amazing story. And the DVD has some really great features, and it really has some excellent behind the scenes information on the movie. The pain that went into putting this film back together. You learn a lot about Georges Méliès and his struggles. And this is a Korean DVD that luckily has English in the language track, so I'm able to watch it in English. And several versions of the film in different narrations, so I'm able to follow the story. It's a silent film, but through the narrations, I'm able to follow what's going on and all that. And it's a really interesting period film to look at, in my opinion. And I was very interested in watching it, and even more so fascinated by how they did things. And the imagination is what I really admire about this movie. The imagination that went into putting this together in 1902. And it's just incredible in terms of sheer imagination and what they could do and what they did in those days. Now, originally, Georges Méliès' intent was to release the film in America because it was a big hit in France, and he believed that it would be an even bigger hit in the U.S. But unfortunately, and unbeknownst to him, some of the film's technicians made copies of the movie and released it in the U.S. without his knowledge. And you know, it's really heart-wrenching in the fact that this film was basically stolen and released in America. It made money, and Méliès didn't make anything off of it. And the fact that, you know, he would go bankrupt is really, really a damn shame. A damn shame. And the documentary that explains all this on the DVD, it's just heart-wrenching. I just felt so badly for this man. Just so badly. And I can only imagine how he must have felt utterly, utterly destroyed inside. The movie took about 3 months to make. And for short film, it had a very, very large budget at the time and was one of the most expensive films made for the time, as it cost about, in U.S. money, it ranges, you know, from about $60,000 to $90,000 in today's dollars. Georges Méliès himself was even in the film. He played one of the background characters looking through a telescope while other characters were featured in the movie. Now, you know, everyone, it's kind of amazing that this movie, A Trip to the Moon, is actually 119 years old in 2020. And that's just incredible, just epically incredible. Another distinction about this movie is that, you know, of the 502 films that Georges Méliès made, A Trip to the Moon is undoubtedly his most well-known movie. Now, sadly, Georges Méliès would not live long enough to see the impact that this movie made. He knew that it was a popular movie, but ultimately, in the entire universe of science fiction, he wouldn't live to see how important this film has been deemed, as he died a very, very long time ago of cancer. I believe it was 1937. And his impact, the impact of this movie, still remains relevant today. So let's give a silent tribute to the accomplishment, Georges Méliès' A Trip to the Moon. Thanks for watching, everybody.